Hi guys, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will create the second type of the bottom sheet, that is model or dialog bottom sheet. For this bottom sheet, again we need to create one more layout resource file. So what we will do is we will right click in our layout folder as we do always to create a layout resource file, and we will create a layout resource file. Now you can name your file anything. I will name it my dialog bottom sheet. That's it. Now you can design your layout or bottom sheet according to your need. So whatever you want to design, you can design. This is an example. So I will design a very simple bottom sheet or bottom sheet dialog or whatever you want to call it. So I will use a linear layout that does match parent and wrap content. Now inside this linear layout, I will create a list view. Let's define the orientation as vertical. And inside this layout, I will create a list view like this. Now we have match parent, wrap content, and I will give this list an ID that is list items, or you can give any ID. Now we will use this layout as our dialog bottom sheet, and to do this we need to create a class. So we will create a class. It is a Kotlin class, and I will name this class as my dialog bottom sheet, or you can name it whatever you want. So I will create a class that is my dialog bottom sheet, and to this class we will extend bottom sheet dialog fragment like this. So we have our class for bottom sheet dialog is ready. Now we will override the function that is override fun on create view, not on create, but on create view. Now inside this function we will return the view or the layout file that we want to show for this bottom sheet dialog. In our case, we created this my persistent bottom sheet. So what we will do is we will inflate this layout using this inflator instance, and we will return it. So here we can simply write return inflator, this inflator dot inflate, and we will inflate the layout that we created. So it is r.layout.myDialogBottomSheet. Then we will pass the container as the root and we will pass false. That's it. We can simply write it like this as well because it is Kotlin. So what we can do is we can remove this. We can put an equals to and it is fine. So this is also fine. You can write in whatever way you want. So our onCreate view is ready. Now inside on activity created, we will initialize our list and we will put some items into the list. So again we overridden the function that is on activity created, and inside this function we will get our list, that is list items. So what I will do here is in my dialog bottom sheet, I will call the list items, and then I will set the adapter. It is equals to array adapter of type string like this. For the first parameter, oops, we don't need the semicolon because it is Kotlin. For the first parameter we will pass the context, so we can call require context. For the next parameter we need to pass our list resource, so we have a predefined list item resource in Android, that is android.r.layout.simple_list_item1. So we are going to use this item. Now the last parameter is the items that we want to display. So what I can do is I can pass a list of, and inside this list of I can pass the items that I want to display. So for example, let's say we have item 1 and 2, 3, 4. That's it. Now everything is fine. Now on the click of a button, we will display this bottom sheet dialog or my dialog bottom sheet. So come back to activity underscore main.xml, and here I will create one more button. So I will copy this button and it is my dialog bottom sheet. So we have the button, and instead of this persistent, I will write expand or show, just simply show bottom sheet. So we have show bottom sheet and the layout is fine. So now come back to main activity, and here when the button is clicked, that is button dialog sheet. So we will attach a click listener like this. Now whenever the button is clicked, I will call my dialog bottom sheet dot show, and here we need to pass two parameters. The first one is the fragment manager, so here we can pass get support fragment manager or support fragment manager for Kotlin. So we have the support fragment manager. For tag, we can pass anything. I am passing an empty string for now. So our dialog bottom sheet is ready. Let me show you by running it. So let's click this button, and you can see we have our dialog bottom sheet here. So it is working absolutely fine. So that is all for this video, friends. And in case you have any problem or confusion, you can leave your comments below, and you can get the link to the source code in the description of this video. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.